Let's say that we want to quickly and easily set up a small file share across our local network. A very simple solution would be to create an SMB file share directly on our router. The SMB protocol was first developed by IBM 40 years ago, and it has been developed by Microsoft since then. But fortunately, it is still free to use for everybody. So it should come as a no surprise that all routerless devices support SMB server functionality out of the box. And if your device has a USB port, just like this brand new L009, you could plug in a flash drive or a full-blown external SSD drive and make this work for large file exchange as well. However, you should keep in mind that it is going to put an extra load on the router's CPU, and the SMB protocol is not most optimized for large file transfers in the first place. Okay, let's go over the simple steps you need to take to make this work. First, you're gonna, of course, need to plug in your Ethernet cable into your router. And then you're gonna need to connect using Winbox. On the router, we just need to go to IP SMB section. As you can see, the default domain name is MS Home and the server is disabled from the start. Let's create a simple share in the share section. Just type add and name followed by the name you want to use. Then go to user and add another user with write access with password and read only set to no. Now I can enable the server. That's all the necessary setup on your router. If you're on Windows machine or say Ubuntu, you just add the SMB share as usual and it will work perfectly. Now, unfortunately, I am on Manjaro KDE Plasma Edition, and KDE is known to have issues with Samba, so I dug a little bit deeper to get some sort of basic functionality going. So let's open up the terminal and do sudo nano slash etc slash samba slash smb.conf. On KDE, this configuration file might not exist at all at first. So if it doesn't, just create it. And the important line that we need to add here is under the global section, you want to have client min protocol set to NT1 because RouterOS supports only Samba versions 1 and version 2.002. The NT1 means that Samba 1 will be supported and KDE is not going to try to force some version 3 or something. So once you've edited the file, just save it. And then you can use a CLI tool that should work perfectly. And if it doesn't, it will give you nice error messages that will tell you exactly what is going wrong. Type SMB client space slash slash the IP of your router slash the name of your share, then space dash capital U space the username you created followed by percentage sign and the password, and that logs you in. If I now create a file, so I created this example text file in my share, and now I do ls, it shows me the file. And if you press tab, you can see that all the most important Samba functions are there. So you can use get space example .txt to download the file. And then you can, of course, remove it with rm, the name of the file. So as you can see, it's gone now. So let me create again. If I go to the file explorer, however, I find that adding a Samba entry, just like before with the IP address slash our share, I'm able to open the share by adding it in this manner. However, the default login method is as a guest, so I won't be able to create any new files. To fix this, we need to go to KDE settings, open system settings and type in Windows share. And there just type in the username and password. After doing that, we can create new text file. And a file showed up on our router. That's about all there is to it. If you enjoyed this content, please subscribe. Thank you for watching. Take care. Thank you.